Okay, in this screencast, we're going to derive the Michaelis-Menten expression for the mechanism that's shown below, which is the classical Michaelis-Menten formalism. We'll try to describe what the real physical behavior is that leads to the observed kinetic dependencies. All right, there are three steps to the Michaelis-Menten mechanism. The enzyme plus substrate reacted to form the enzyme-substrate complex. Right, and so that is the necessary first attachment of the substrate to produce a bound substrate on the enzyme, or ES. Right, once that is in place, the substrate can come back off of the enzyme in reaction 2 to make E plus S, or we can have the case where the enzyme-substrate complex in reaction 3 reacts to form our product P plus free enzyme. All right, and so if we're going to start deriving kinetic expression, we're going to treat each of these as elementary steps. And we will write the rate expression for each of these steps based on the molecularity. And so we're interested most often in the rate of formation of our product, P. And so we'll write out the expression for that rate of formation of our product. And it's just equal to some rate constant times the concentration of the enzyme-substrate complex. The concentration of the enzyme-substrate complex is a difficult thing to actually measure during an experiment. Right, this tends to be a short-lived species. And so we want to develop relationships that allow us to solve for this concentration of the enzyme-substrate complex in terms of things that we can actually measure. To do that, what we're going to use is a technique called the steady-state approximation, and we'll assume that the concentrations of the different forms of the enzyme will be largely invariant. Change of the enzyme-substrate complex with respect to time. So in other words, there's a steady level of the enzyme-substrate complex over time during the reaction. So that's equal to zero, and we can write all the reactions that eliminate and that produce enzyme-substrate complex, and the net rate of production minus consumption should be equal to zero. And so the enzyme-substrate complex is produced in reaction 1 and consumed in reactions 2 and 3. And so we can write this out in terms of the different kinetic expressions based on the molecularity for those steps. So it's produced in reaction 1. We have a K1 times concentration of the enzyme times concentration of substrate, and then consumed in step 2. So we have a rate constant associated with that expression, all right, times the concentration of enzyme-substrate complex. And then we also have a K3 times the concentration of enzyme-substrate complex. All right, now we need to just do some algebra, and we can relate the concentration of free enzyme to the concentration of enzyme-substrate complex. We can solve for the concentration of enzyme is equal to this collection of rate constants and the concentration of the substrate on the right-hand side relative to the concentration of enzyme-substrate complex. So now we can eliminate an unknown. We have an extra equation that relates our concentration of enzyme to concentration of enzyme-substrate complex. Right, the next thing that we can do is what's known as a site balance, or an overall enzyme balance, and we can recognize that the total concentration of enzyme that we originally added, which may have during the reaction, may either have substrate or be free, has to be constant. All right, so we added the total amount of enzyme, assuming it's not destroyed as a catalyst in the system, then it should be, the total amount should be fixed. But during the reaction, some of it will be free enzyme, so the concentration of E, and sometimes will be enzyme-substrate complex. And so now we can plug in from the equation directly above that to solve for the total concentration of enzyme in terms of only the enzyme-substrate complex. Now we can take an additional algebraic step, and we can solve for the concentration of enzyme-substrate complex in terms of this total concentration of enzyme that, again, is fixed. That's how much we know we added at the beginning of the reaction, or the concentration we know we reacted. And now that's in terms of some, again, this collection of different rate constants for our three reactions and the concentration of substrate, the reactant that we're actually reacting away. And then we can do a little bit more algebra and multiply by the concentration of numerator and denominator by the concentration of substrate. All right, and then we get the classical Michaelis-Menten form. And we can take these different rate constants, K2 plus K3 over K1, and define that as the Michaelis constant, which is Km. And you can notice that this Michaelis constant, if we look at our reaction steps, is equal to the ease with the rate with which the substrate comes off of the enzyme divided by the rate constants associated with the substrate attaching to the enzyme. Right, so the higher the Michaelis constant, the more rapid the detachment of the substrate from the enzyme, either as unreacted substrate or as product, is relative to the attachment of the substrate to the enzyme. And so now we can re-express this rate of product formation, which is, again, K3 times the concentration of ES. But now we have an expression for the concentration of enzyme-substrate complex that we'll just plug in from the algebra that we have in the step immediately above. Okay, and what's often done at this point is that we collect, this is our final result in a way, but often we'll collect this term K3 times the concentration of total enzyme and call that our maximum rate or maximum velocity, Vmax. All right, so that our rate is equal to Vmax times the concentration of substrate divided by the Michaelis constant plus the concentration of substrate. So let's take a look at some of this behavior to get more of a physical idea for what this rate expression means. It will do this in the context of a Michaelis-Menten plot. And in a Michaelis-Menten plot, we can write the rate of formation of product on the y-axis, the concentration of substrate on the x-axis, and just plot what this expression actually means. And we'll see that when we plot this rate, right, we'll have two basic regimes by looking at the two different terms in the denominator. Right, at very low concentration of substrate, Km, our Michaelis constant, will be much greater than our concentration of substrate, right, in the limit that the concentration of substrate approaches zero. And therefore, our rate will be equal to Vmax times the concentration of substrate over Km. Or in other words, there will be a linear relationship between the rate and the concentration of substrate. Right, so we will cancel out the concentration of substrate in the denominator because that is close to zero. And at low concentration of S, we'll draw a linear relationship. Now, at high concentration of S, we have a different situation where we can assume that the concentration of S, if it gets high enough as it approaches infinity, it will be higher than the Michaelis constant. And so the converse will be true as far as which term dominates denominator if we get to high enough concentration of S. Right? And we'll be able to cross out the Km, that expression, and we'll see the rate of reaction at high concentration of substrate is independent of substrate concentration. And the rate is equal to a constant Vmax. So the fastest our rate can be at substrate concentration is Vmax, so it's level there. And then we realize that we have a gradual transition from this first order behavior to zeroth order behavior in terms of the concentration of substrate, right, where we have the maximum again at Vmax. Another thing that we can realize is that if we go to the y-axis to a rate that's Vmax over 2, that x-axis will be equal to Km at that point. We'll get Vmax over 2 when Km is equal to the concentration of S. Okay, and we can prove that algebraically. Okay, and so if we look at this physically, at low concentration of S, what we mostly have in our system is free enzyme. All right, so that free enzyme is available to do the reaction because it's not bound to a lot of substrate. And so as soon as we add more substrate, we can get more reaction. And therefore, the rate is linearly related to the concentration of substrate. All right, in contrast, at a high concentration of S, our enzyme is mostly bound up to the substrate. We have so much substrate in our system that is occupying all of the enzyme sites. And so we don't get any advantage from adding in more substrate in terms of having a faster rate. All the enzyme is already bound up, and so adding a little bit more substrate doesn't help us achieve a higher rate. And so what we see is that Michaelis-Menten gives us a way to describe the transition from a case where we have a low concentration of substrate to a high concentration of substrate. And because of that change in the amount of free enzyme, we get a change in the kinetic behavior from first order to zeroth order.